If you grip your mouse as if you are aiming in a game and then flip it around, what direction is your sensor pointing? If there is an obvious skew like this where it's pointing out to the side, then you have some easy aim gains up for grabs. If there's no obvious skew, you don't have anything to worry about, but you could learn a thing or two for the future if you ever change your grip style or mouse. What we're looking at here is the sensor orientation. I've been using a correction for this for 4 years now and feel like it's time for an updated video on the topic with my latest knowledge and findings. You can still jump into Paint and see if you can draw horizontal lines or not, but I do have a new method to show you. So what's the problem here? Well, when we really break things down, we're ultimately aiming with our hands. Where we point it and move it is what we expect to see mirrored on our screen. If I move left, the crosshair should move left. If I move right, it should also move right. The mouse itself is just the interface between our body and what happens on screen. Having a skewed mouse sensor damages this interface. Up is no longer up, right is no longer right. Everything gets shifted around by a few degrees. Recently, I started playing Fragpunk and also changed from my OP1 back to my old main, the G303, which has a more dramatic skew, but I didn't update my sensor orientation, which led to some frustration with my sniper flick shots. Check this out. Here I am, lined up with the head, and I'm aiming to the right at the head. But by the end of the flick, my crosshair is all the way down here. And then immediately after, I'm lined up with the head, aiming to the left, and my crosshair ends way up here. Does that skew look familiar to you? And then after fixing my sensor orientation, I was landing shots like this, where that skew is nowhere to be seen. This impacts more than just flicks, but that is a handy visual example. Fortunately, we are extremely capable of adapting to and compensating for these issues. There have been a number of famous experiments where people wear inversion goggles for days or even weeks at a time. After a couple of days, their perception adapts and they see normally again, and can walk around normally and even ride a bike. What I'm getting at is that even though you may have a skewed sensor, you could very well be compensating for it so there isn't a noticeable problem. But two things are still happening. First, your hand's range of motion is compromised. For example, if you skew to the right, aiming here and here is really easy and comfortable, but aiming here and here is harder to get to and requires some awkward arm movement. With a corrected sensor orientation, which I'll cover in just a moment, we open up our range of motion and balance out these movements. And the second problem you encounter, even if you've learned to compensate, is that you're aiming through a filter. You can think of it like this extra layer of processing that you have to do to correct your mouse movements. This can be mostly fine, but filters like this tend to break down when you need them most. When you enter a stressful aiming situation, you want intuitive and instinctive feeling aim. If you've ever gone from your comfortable mid or low sensitivity and tried high sensitivity, you'll know exactly what I'm talking about. After a few hours or days, you can get to a point where your aim feels pretty good. But it does take a conscious effort to control your crosshair and to not over-aim. Then you have situations like being unexpectedly shot, and when you flick to them, you massively over-aim and have to make a big correction. In that moment, the filter you were applying to make high sensitivity work for you broke down. Stress and time pressure are very good at disrupting these filters. Okay, so how do you actually correct your sensor orientation? Fortunately, companies are finally catching on to how useful this can be and are adding settings to their mouse software. Razer's new mice have a rotation setting, and I believe the Aim Labs mouse also has this, and there may be some others out there now doing this too. If your mouse software does not have a rotation setting, you can use RawAccel instead. I know it's super annoying to watch a guide and then see that you need to download something, I totally get it, but RawAccel is widely used, super lightweight and doesn't sell you anything. It's the same tool people use to play with mouse acceleration. It's fully signed with a 1 second delay on write, so it cannot be used to cheat and is currently considered safe by anti-cheat programs. The link is down below. If you have any other concerns or questions about it, I've linked to their FAQ in the description and their Discord. Once you install it and restart your PC, open it up. Don't worry about all of this, we're just looking at the rotation field, which is what lets us change our sensor orientation. I have a new method for finding your optimal setting, which feels more reliable and genuine without needing so much iteration. Open up Paint and move it to a second monitor. If you have a single screen setup, open this video on your phone or a laptop and have Paint open on your monitor. At the end of this video, in the final chapter, I've included this footage of tracking a target. When doing this test, go to the end of this video, hit play, and click and hold down mouse 1 on the paint canvas and pretend that you are the one tracking the target on your screen. Use the same grip you would in game and really try to do this intently. Don't look at what you're drawing, stay focused on the target and the tracking. At the end, you should have a bunch of lines that generally point in a certain direction. What you see here is how you aim without that filter. From here, you can adjust your rotation setting and try again and go back and forth until you get it right. Or something I've been doing now when I try a new mouse and want my rotation setting is to save that image. Open this site, which I'll also link to below, and add the image as the background. Then move the base of the protractor to the middle of your distribution. If you have a visible edge, I find it easier to line it up there, but anywhere works. Then click to add a marker and line this up with the general direction of your swipes. Then add another marker and line it up horizontally at 0. This number shows your offset. So a result of 7 means I would type in minus 7 into RawAccel. And now my lines are straight, and if I do the test again, it's also nice and straight. When you take your new rotation setting for a spin in game, it may feel a bit weird at first, especially with large movements, but you do get used to it quickly. And you may find that you need to use decimals to get a bit more precise. Ultimately, the whole point of this rotation setting is to have you aiming at your best. So feel free to iterate away from whatever result the tests gave you if you aren't happy with how it feels and you find something better. You can check out my Clawmate mouse mod, gaming sleeves, and more over at struthgaminggear.com. And I've just launched the demo for my game Polyglock over on Steam, so it would mean a lot to me if you could take a look and slap it on your wishlist. And here is that tracking footage. Thanks for watching.